Here we are going to use Corero's SecureWatch analytics to check the time to mitigation on the Corero Smartwall appliance. This graph is updating every second. The first attack to come in is a DNS reflection attack. You'll see that there is no part of that attack that's allowed. The time to mitigation is effectively 0 seconds, as the Corero appliance blocks this attack per packet. There are several categories of attacks that cannot be blocked per packet. This is either because there are zero-day attacks, or they consist of benign traffic that is sent at a very high rate. One of these examples is the ICMP flood. There are several types of floods, but either way, the Corero Smartwall will detect it and automatically mitigate within a few seconds. So you can see that small green spike at the beginning, that was part of the attack that was allowed for about 2 seconds. Then the Corero Smartwall, using its smart rules, will block the rest of the attack for as long as it runs. Another way the Corero Smartwall can block attacks is with autonomic response. Autonomic response is basically closing the loop between analytics and the mitigation device. So in this case, the Smartwall sends information to the analytics, queries are run to find potential attack vectors, and those are fed back to the Smartwall. The next attack is a small volume ACK flood, which the SecureWatch analytics has detected and sent in some mitigation information to the Smartwall. You'll note the time to mitigation is about 4 or 5 seconds. By using these three types of DDoS mitigation, the Corero Smartwall handles a wide breadth of DDoS attacks in real time without affecting the background traffic.